Allow me to introduce myself. I am Amiga, a remarkable machine that has captured the hearts of people around the world. With my lightning-fast processing speed and exquisite design, I am truly one of the wonders of the modern age. Perhaps you remember our past adventures together. I'll show you a few tricks now before we move on. Remember, I'm not the same Amiga that I used to be. I'm now 4,000 times faster, and you don't need to restart me after launching every program. This system is a self-booting CoffinOS system, which is simply perfect in every way. However, because there was no YouTube or Facebook 20 years ago, please don't launch these functions on the browser here. For this purpose, we have a different XFCE desktop interface running on Debian, which makes everything possible here, but I'll explain more about that. CoffinOS is a completely free AmigaOS, and you don't need to register it. All the programs and functions that are available on this computer have been downloaded from public websites, but they have been professionally configured and collected into one whole. There are almost 4,000 games, lots of demos, and utility programs. Do you want more? Direct access to AmiNet and a shared work disk can be found on every desktop in all the installed systems. Now, to proceed further or to restart the system without proceeding further, press F12. This is the FS-UAE menu. Hover over the cross in the top right corner with the arrow keys and press Enter. Do you think it's complicated? No. Watch this video until the end. This is where you connect to the internet to make it work in other emulated Amiga OS systems. Here are the most important functions pulled out onto the desktop. There are shortcuts to programs and other operating systems here. In case of any issues, you can always call us or watch this video again carefully. The HD work icon is particularly important, as I mentioned earlier, it is a shortcut to the AmigaOS disk available in all systems, but mainly to access the Amiga partition from the Linux system. Here you can find a shortcut that launches the Mycroft AI voice assistant. It is something like Alexa, but more advanced. After launching Mycroft AI, you need to register it to be able to communicate with the computer using voice commands.
Before we get started, go to account.
It's enough to click on the Firefox icon located on the bottom panel and follow the registration process step by step. I highly recommend doing it immediately after connecting to the internet. After the first launch, Mycroft AI will repeat a 6-digit code which needs to be entered in the appropriate place during the registration process. If everything goes well, and it's very simple, just say in a commanding tone, "Hey Mycroft," and Mycroft will be ready for your commands.
I'm connected to the internet and need to be activated. Open your browser and visit account.mycroft.ai/pair to register this device.
Mycroft also works with Amiga OS running and is sometimes very useful.
Register this device with the code F as in Foxtrot, M as in Mike, M as in Mike, L as in London, X as in X-ray, U as in uniform.
Here is FS-UAE Arcade, something you will love right away. All the games ever created are here. The game database is automatically updated from the internet, and if any new games appear, they will be visible here after some appropriate steps are taken. All Amigas are emulated here, from Amiga 500 through CD32 to Amiga 4000 or CDTV. And now a demonstration of other systems. Don't get me wrong, I don't want to show you unnecessary things here. It's more about showing you almost everything in a nutshell. This project is still being developed and improved, and if you follow our YouTube channel, you already know that. Not everything in our commercial project is available. We are not allowed to sell some of the systems, but they are shown here as fully functional, and you can find their configurations in the configuration folder.
Hi Amiga.
It's also worth noting that I'm an emulated Amiga. I'm fully functional and useful, but I'm also somewhat virtual, which gives me a lot of advantages, and I know that I'm making an impression, isn't that right? Of course, on the PC side you can use this computer as a regular computer. There are text editors and a full Office suite available. The interface is friendly, simple, and intuitive. Here is MorphOS, my new generation. This is a demo version that runs for 30 minutes and then slows down significantly, requiring a restart. Unfortunately, MorphOS does not yet support emulation and requires a computer with a PowerPC processor to be used. I think that's enough for you to safely operate this supercomputer that I'm present in every step of the way. Or do I think so? Find out for yourself. Unfortunately, I can't show you everything. We would run out of time and I don't want to bore you. So let's turn off this computer.